Right, guys, so basically, besides looking at the new upcoming games, I do look at demos and stuff like that. It says Forza Motorsport, I don't know if that's new. It's coming out on the 10th of October 2023. I will go into just to see what's new about that. Let's see. Like I said, I'm only looking for games that are new, you know? I think a lot of these I've already done demos for, so you know, if you see them, like they're marked on wishlist, it's probably I did a demo on it, or I haven't, or I have, I'm not sure. Right, this one's called Crossfire Sierra Squad. Right, so I'm gonna be just showing demos, guys. These are not demos, actually, the trailers of games. Either they're out already, or this is called Fire Farm. And it's coming out on the 8th of September 2023. So what I like to do is put it on my wish list and follow it as well. It's RPG, farming sim, magic, cozy, co-op. It says single player, online co-op, Steam achievements, partial control support, Steam cloud. So that might mean you need a mini keyboard with you. You know, it's one of those Bluetooth type keyboards. It says GeForce GTX 460, AMD HD 6850, or Intel UHD 620. So this is going to be like 1 gig of VRAM. I mean, if you can use Intel on this, then you don't really need a powerful processor. GeForce GTX at 660, AMD Radeon HD 7870. So I'm guessing 1.5 gigabyte of VRAM to about 2 gigs of VRAM. So anything from 1 gig of VRAM to 2 gigs of VRAM. It's saying it's gonna cost $33.50. Deluxe edition is $50. It's coming out in September 8th. Right.
When you're ready, we'll be right here. Fae Farm, available September 8th on Steam. Pre-purchase now.
Right, so this game is coming out on 8th of September. You can pre-purchase it now on Steam. The lowest it goes for is about $33.50. And Deluxe Edition is $50. I mean, it looks really good, guys. It's called Fae Farm. That's F-A-E and then Farm, F-A-R-M. Let's see, is there anything else I can show you guys? I mean, there's some new stuff in here. There's this, I don't know what that is. Right, I'm gonna be just showing you some trailers, guys. These do look like new games. There's a new X-Men game as well, I'm noticing. Like I said, I would normally get demos, but demos do take up a lot of space on my Steam Deck, and then I end up not playing the game, and then it's like, you know, it's just... I'm not trying to say anything, but I'm just saying if I don't play the game, then it's like sticking up space. This is Rune Factory 3 Special. Right, that's Rune Factory 3 special, and it's coming out in September 5th, 2023. I'm just gonna add this to my wish list, follow it as well. This is basically $35. Digital Deluxe is $45. Single player Steam achievements, Steam trading cards, partial control support, Steam Cloud. There's different languages: English, French, German, Spanish, and Japanese. It does say it's got a few more languages attached to this. It says pre-purchase offer, you get Riker's outfit. So you'll get a special like prize with that. It states you can use Intel Iris Xe graphics, or if you've got an Intel PC with Xe graphics, this game will work. If you've got a GTX 1650, that's like 4 gigs of VRAM, it will work as well. So you don't need anything fancy to run this game on, which is pretty cool. I'm just gonna look and see if there's any other games that I've missed here. The Sonic Superstars. Is that a new game? That's a new game. Oh well. Right, so this is Sonic Superstars. So that is coming out on 17 October 2023. To pre-purchase Sonic Superstars is $55. The Deluxe Edition featuring Lego is $60. Single player, Steam achievements, full controller support. It supports English, French, Italian, German, Spanish, but it does say 10 languages, so there's some other languages not showing. GeForce GTX 750. It says a NVIDIA GeForce GTX 750. That's 2 gigs of VRAM, AMD Radeon HD 7790, 2 gigs of VRAM, NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1070, 8 gigs of VRAM, AMD Radeon RX Vega 56, 8 gigs of VRAM. I think it said something here about pre-order now and receive the Lego Eggman character skin. It says the Sonic Superstars Deluxe Edition featuring Lego contains Sonic Superstars and the Deluxe, and the Digital Deluxe upgrade featuring Lego, which includes Lego Fan Pack, Sonic Rabbit Skin, Mech Parts, battle mode, bonus main menu wallpapers, digital art book, and mini original soundtrack. The mech parts, I think it's like this, what this, so you'll get exclusive Lego fun pack, rabbit skin, it's exclusive mech parts for battle mode. Yeah, so whatever this says here, that's what you get if you go for the Lego, which is $60. Just a $5 difference, guys. It's not major. Sonic Superstars does come out on the 17th of October, 2023. In terms of graphics, I'm thinking 2 gigs of VRAM. That's definitely going to work on Steam Deck. I wouldn't be worried in terms of if you're thinking this will work on Steam, it will. Steam Deck does support for up to 4 gigs of VRAM. Alright, I did miss one of the games. I was just checking to see. I'm looking at this one. It's called Medic Pacific War. I'm going to show a trailer there. This one is Crossfire Sierra Squad. It's already out, guys. Well, it's coming out on the 28th of August. So, I think tomorrow, right? Comes out tomorrow.
It's Brad White from Smilegate. Excited to be here today at the Upload VR Showcase to give you a glimpse of some never-before-seen gameplay from our upcoming VR game, Crossfire Sierra Squad. The gameplay you're watching... Greetings, mercenaries. It's Fred White from Smilegate. Excited to be here today at the Upload VR Showcase to give you a glimpse of some never-before-seen gameplay from our upcoming VR game, Crossfire Sierra Squad. Now, the gameplay you're watching today takes place in a game mode called Realism Mode. It's a challenging mode that offers very little guidance, no ammo indicator, and low starting HP for both you and your enemies. Now there are 39 different weapons you can use in the game. You'll notice I'm carrying two pistols, the Eagle 50 and the AP-18C. They're useful for both short and medium range combat. I'll duck in here and reload. So I could pick up these pistols off the table, but I think I'll pass for now. It's time to reload again. I'm going to step out and get that other guy. He's got a shield, so I need to be on target. Oh, got him in there. One way back there I haven't seen before. So I'll reload. I'm going to check this room on the right, and oh, got me. Crossfire Sierra Squad launches this August on PlayStation VR 2 and Steam. Wishlist today, and we'll see you soon, mercenaries.
That game's also a VR game, so I think I think you're going to need a headset. It supports VR. And it says VR only, so yeah. That was Crossfire Sierra Squad. That's coming out on the 29th August, so 2 days from now. I think on Tuesday. And it's only VR, so you need a VR headset for that. Right, I'm going to look at Medic Pacific War.
Let me tell you the true story of a medic during the Pacific War. My story. Everything started with Pearl Harbor. It all seemed peaceful. Until the war started that day for me and everyone in my company. And so did my... Let me tell you... story of a medic during the Pacific War. My story. Everything started at Pearl Harbor. It all seemed peaceful until the war started that day for me and everyone in my company. And so did my new life. I saw things that day that would change everything I thought I knew about mankind. From that moment, I followed my comrades to witness the fall of the Philippines and participated in Operation Watchtower. The battle of Guadalcanal. I was but an aspiring medic at the start of the Pacific War, but the horror of war meant it didn't matter. My brothers in arms needed me, and I had to quickly find out how to properly do my job. I wasn't ready. One of the first lessons I learned was to treat the critically wounded first. Heavy bleeding, tears, burns, and even amputated limbs. The day to think I saw it. My old life was over. And every moment became a dilemma. And comrades lying on the ground with different wounds. I couldn't save everyone. I had to make dreadful choices about who should be treated first and saved. But that was only the beginning. Time was of the essence as they were bleeding out. Depending on their wounds, I learned to slowly drag them when they were bleeding a lot, and to carry them on my shoulder to quickly get them to medical outposts. This was also where I got most of my supplies. I didn't always get everything, so so I made do with what I had, or checked other outposts. Bandages, tourniquets, gauze, those were easy to find. But boy, morphine and plasma, they were lacking. But if healing the wounded had been the only thing I had to worry about, it would have been too easy. Dangers surrounded me at every given moment. I was under fire from bullets, bombs dropping on the battlefield. Or I needed to slip through enemy lines, under their watchful eyes. Losing sight of any of that would have meant that my brothers in arms and I would die. That's why I became a medic.
That's called Medic Specific War. Comes out next year, 2024. Just looking at single player, team achievements, full controller support. This one's quite interesting because it says GeForce GTX 1050. So 1050 is like a 2 gigs of VRAM. Radeon HD 7850, 2 gigs. RX 550. Max recommended is GTX 1080. So that's anything from 2 gigs of VRAM to 8 gigs. But what I find interesting is that GTX 1050, because anybody knows, if you know this quite well, then basically you'd know that that is not the GTX 1050, like I'm saying, isn't that great for games. Join our server on Discord. So they've got Discord here. They got a Discord community, basically. To me, it seems like you'd be supplying medic stuff. I mean, look at that. There's not much combat. I mean, you probably would be involved in combat, but I'm just saying. This will be interesting to actually see how it plays out. I'm gonna play the second trailer.
Leave me.
You know what this game reminds me of? It reminds me of that Tank Squad thing as well. Tank Squad has got a similar outlook on the game of war. Because with Tank Squad, I don't know if it's out yet, but it's similar to this. This guy's down. I'm just saying, Tank Squad is similar because you work as a team. So basically, you are in a tank. Let me play you Tank Squad. You'll understand what I mean. Right, so if you took anything from the Tank Squad, it's the same thing. You're working as a team, you're in that tank. I don't think you can leave the tank unless you're repairing it. So it's going to be interesting how they make this game look. It says Q4 2023, so Tank Squad. It's got a single player online co-op, LAN co-op. So this is going to be like multiplayer, obviously. Just wanted to look at the graphics. This is a GTX 570 HD 6970. Then it does say 4 gigs of VRAM recommended. GeForce GTX 980, AMD Radeon R9 Fury or better. So I'm just guessing anything from 2 gigs. Anything from 2 gigabytes onwards is going to work with this game. So I mean, it would work nicely on the Steam Deck. Actually, Tank Squad would work. I mean, it's recommended. It's just 4 gigs of VRAM. So obviously, I'm just taking that the Steam Deck can go up to 4 gigs. Like I said, this main video is just about trailers at the moment. But I will be playing some games. My games are always the same thing. So I mean, you know, there's nothing new about my games. That's what I'm saying. Right, I'll finish them off by showing these other games here. Right, let me just jump into this one. This is Fate Samurai Remnant. That's coming out in September 29 this year. Thank you. was the first trailer. I'm gonna play the second trailer.
のようなものだ。俺の目的は変わらない。欲とするものはただ一つ。それならば、美を生き残ることはできんの。
Right, that was the second trailer. The game itself is called Fate Samurai Remnant, and that's coming out on the 29th of September 2023. It's an RPG, single player Steam achievements, full control support. Steam Cloud, it costs $55, Digital Deluxe is $90. It says it comes with a bonus. I don't know what the bonus is. Right, so basically, you get a season pass with DLC times 3. You get the game, digital art book, and soundtrack. You get season pass bonus, Halloween relic sword mounting. So it says this. In this set, the main game, digital art book, soundtrack, season pass, featuring 3 additional episodes, season pass bonus, Halloween relic sword mountings equipment. It says, note, the content and release dates are subject to change without notice. Please please visit the official website for more information. Right, so I'm gonna look at the graphics, like what you need for the graphics, because this game looks really good. Right, in terms of graphics, NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1060 with 3 gigs of VRAM, AMD Radeon RX 570, 4 gigs of VRAM. Recommended, NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2066 gigs of VRAM, AMD Radeon RX 5600 XT. 6 gigs of VRAM. So anything from 3 to 6 gigs to run this game. I would like to believe that Steam Deck can definitely play this game. As I've said, Steam Deck does go up to 4 gigs of VRAM. I think this game would work beautifully on Steam Deck. It's coming out on the 29th of September this year. Alright, so I'm gonna play a few more trailers, guys. This is called Ying Yang Street, comes out on 30 August, so it's coming out this week. There's a demo if you want to download the demo. There's a Discord. I'm just going to read this. Basically just saying 4 gigs of VRAM, 4 gigs of RAM. It doesn't say anything about VRAM, about the actual graphics required for the game. It's a single player Steam achievement. There's a demo of the game if you want to play the demo. Ying Yang Street. Gonna play the trailer now. This game comes out this week, guys. There's no actual price on it, so it did say it's a cube type of game, GameCube game. This is Mega Man X Dive Offline.
objects, memories, mistakes. They sink in time, touch the bottom and go to sleep. Silence is full of ghosts. And here, voices can only come from the deep. Thank you.